You guys asked for it in the poll, and here we are with this video. So every week, I'll start around Friday to ask what kind of video you guys want to see and have ready for you guys in a couple of days. But I want to ask you guys a question. Are we about to embark on an American 60K rear engine car revolution? European rear engine cars like the Porsche 718, that's 60K. The Lotus Evora GT, that's 96K. And the Lotus Emira is about to come next year around the 70K price range. Last year, Chevy went bold and brought in a rear engine C8 Corvette that put everyone on notice because it is the cheapest and fastest car of the rear engine format that you can buy at 59K. But what if I told you that the other members of the big three won't go gently into the good night? So I'm gonna make a case for the Viper and the Thunderbird to come in and slay the C8 in this video. So let's get to the stuff. An interesting new report comes out that Ford has a C8 Z51 package car running around most likely doing performance benchmarks. As I said in the intro, Chevy has put everyone on notice with the C8 last year. If you look at the C8 2020 production year numbers, we have 20K just in the first year. In 2020, there was 2,600 Hellcat Chargers and 3,800 Hellcat Challengers. Ford only made around 5,000 GT Finder cars. Chevy made twice the amount of C8 Corvettes that can outperform every vehicle that his rival currently makes during COVID. Let that sink in for a second. And we haven't even seen the Z06, the E-Ray, the ZR1, or even the Zora. Now let me make a case for the Viper financially. In the Viper video, I talked about how Dodge could use the tech from the 4C and the MC20 to make a sub-100K rear-engine carbon fiber chassis Viper. They already have a plant in place to build it by having it done at Maserati, just like the 4C, the MC20, the upcoming Dodge Hornet, imported back to the US. The Viper name is still trademarked, and the electric version of the MC20 is also already in development, and we can easily get a EV Viper done very quickly for low cost. So Dodge is in a great place if you don't go that route. Back in 2018, FCA CEO Sergio said that the Viper wasn't in their 5-year plan. But just a few days ago, newly crowned Stellantis CEO Tavares wouldn't confirm nor deny that the Viper was in the works. So we didn't get a no, and yet we see the Viper popping up here and there in promotional videos. I don't see any other discontinued products like the Avenger, the Neon, the Dart, the SRT10, the Caliber, or the Nitro always in the background. So fingers crossed for the Viper. Now let's shift over to the Thunderbird. In 2018, Ford said they'll stop making all passenger cars except for the Mustang, and now the Ford GT is about in production next year. The Thunderbird was just trademarked in January of this year for a car they haven't used in decades. We just saw Ford reuse the old Lightning name for an electric F-150, and now another electric-centric name has come back, the Thunderbird. If you look at 11 different generations of the Thunderbird, sometimes it's a two-seater, a four-seater, a hardtop, a convertible. It's Ford's Swiss Army knife of a nameplate that wear whatever hat that Ford needs at the time, and now that time could be a two-seater rear engine C8 Corvette competitor. Just look at how the lineup could look like in a couple of years. Chevy, if they don't cancel the Camaro, could have a four-seat two-door Camaro, a mid-engine two-seat Corvette. Dodge could have a four-seat two-door Challenger and a mid-engine Viper, and Ford could have the Mustang and the Thunderbird. So the people who still need a four-seat two-door car can have either Camaro, a Mustang, or a Challenger. People who want to step up to a two-seat only American supercar can have a Corvette, a Viper, or a Thunderbird. Unless Ford copies the Koenigsegg Gamera, I don't see the Mustang ain't going rear engine, because some people need to carry a third person from time to time or need the extra storage behind their seat. Now let me give you a fun fact. From 1955 to 1957, the first generation of the Thunderbird, Ford made 53,166 cars in 3 years. From 1953 to 1957, Chevy only sold 14,266 C1 Corvettes. The Thunderbird is a great nameplate to bring back the stick it to Chevy, just like Dodge just did recently in the video I discussed about the Cuda with the Hammerhead Shark reference. Now let's look at plans that this Thunderbird could be built at. As I said earlier, Ford discontinued other passenger cars, so they have plants not running to full capacity. One plant they can use is the Wayne Stamping Assembly plant where they used to make the Focus at. Or they can use Flat Rock that makes the Mustang right now. That plant made up until last year the Mustang and the Lincoln Continental. If you look at this article back in 2017, Ford was going to invest $700 million into this plant. So maybe that expansion could be used to build this new rear engine based Thunderbird. The Ford GT has been built by other companies contracted to Ford, but with the Thunderbird, they can take what they learned from the GT and then build it in-house to save money. Let's talk about engines real quick. They already have a 3.5 liter 660 horsepower EcoBoost engine in the GT based on the Raptor that gets a 0 to 60 in 3 seconds, close to what the C8 does. So Ford already has an engine to work with. There are reports out there that Ford is working on a hybrid Mustang that will probably debut in 2023 as well. So that's money saved on a hybrid drivetrain and a new engine for the Thunderbird. Let's look at other ways that Ford can save money on the project. In 2024, Stellantis is going to move to 4 modular platforms. Ford, on the other hand, says they're going to go to 5 modular platforms to build all their vehicles off of. So they can make make the Mustang and the Thunderbird be based on the same platform in the same plant to save money. They already did R&D in the GT. Take some of that tech and apply it to the Thunderbird. That's money saved. There's plenty of time to get a Thunderbird development out in a few years with all these dominoes falling in the right place. Dodge will have a high-power all-electric car in 2024 that will be the fastest car they ever produce. Could be a Challenger, could be a Cuda, could be a Viper. But Ford has to get the ball rolling, and maybe the Thunderbird will be the answer. The 1,000 horsepower Corvette Zora is also expected in 2024 as well. So we have a clear competitor in the C8 Corvette. We have an engine they can use. We can have a hybrid drivetrain that's already in the works. And Ford already has a rear-engine supercar that they can water down and make the Thunderbird with. So I gave you the business case of the Thunderbird happening, but let me go over three reasons why C is not going to happen. Well, at least just the name. Number one, now I'm going to say this, and I know I'm going to ruffle some feathers, but while I believe the current GT is a beautiful car, at the same time, to me, it's like the dumbest car you can buy at $500,000. The 2005 GT was 140K MSRP, and people are now drinking the blue Kool-Aid with a new GT at an eye-watering 450K MSRP. A 720S, 120K cheaper, can walk a GT if you look at Drag Time's video. If you look at Hennessy's video, it can barely walk a 200K Huracan. This is why I say the GT is way overpriced. I can understand 200K, maybe 250K, and this is a problem for me for the Thunderbird. How can Ford justify making a sub 100K car that complete with a C8 Corvette and not make GT owners feel like an idiot for spending over 400K for a car that's not even fast in the first place? I looked all over YouTube and I cannot find a GT versus C8 video. Now, Car and Driver tested the C8 0-60 at 2.8 seconds. They tested the Ford GT 0-60 at 3 seconds. Now, the GT will eventually catch up to the Corvette, but the Corvette is only $60,000. We haven't even gotten to like a Z06, an E-Ray, a ZR1, a Zora. Cars are going to be way cheaper than the Ford GT. Now, it's kind of hard for me to believe that they're going to make a Thunderbird within 2 years of the Ford GT getting pushed out of production, because production does end next year. The only way I can see Ford getting away with making a car faster than the GT is by going fully electric. Hybrid may be pushing it, but making an electric-only car, that'll probably get you by GT owners not feeling pissed off. Now, the number two problem is Ford's naming scheme. It just downright confusing. You got the Ford GT, the Mustang GT, and then they made a Mustang-inspired crossover called the Mustang Mach-E with a GT package. Then they go back and bring the Mustang Mach-1 back. I'm like so confused. Who thought it was a bright idea to give a crossover the Mustang name? I mean, literally every other Ford SUV either has an E or F for a first name. Other than the Flex, all the other SUVs from Ford are either Edge, Explorer, Escape, Expedition. I mean, why don't you follow one of those trends? I mean, you could have canceled the Edge and called it Edge EV. So Ford, whoever picked the Mach-E name, don't let them pick the name for this new two-door rear engine car, because I don't want them to come up with some goofy name like the Mustang GT500E or the Lightning Bird or whatever. And last but not least, number three, just the name Thunderbird in general. The origin of the name comes from Native Americans. It is a powerful spirit in the form of a bird. Heck, look at the Thunderbird logo and tell me there's gonna be some problem with some Native Americans in the near future. And just in the last 12 months alone, the Indians have changed their name to the Guardians. Washington lost their name. Braves had to get approval to keep their name. Ram confirmed that a mid-sized truck was coming, but would not call the truck a Dakota because they specifically admitted saying that name during Solana's EV day. Jeep Cherokee and Mojave package names are on the chopping block. They want the Chiefs to change their names. They also had a problem with them running a horse across the field, so it can't be used anymore. They also have a problem with the Tomahawk chop. So if all this stuff is a problem, I don't know how Ford is going to be able to use the Thunderbird and the Thunderbird logo, which signifies one of their spirits. Just saying. And that's it for this video, guys. Hopefully some more news will leak out about this potential Thunderbird or whatever goofy name this car could potentially have. Let me know down in the comments what you guys think. And make sure you help support the channel by liking the video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. And until the next video, I'm out.